In this lesson, we will look at code blocks in Dynamo. Code blocks are a unique feature in Dynamo that brings together visual programming with DesignScript. DesignScript is a text-based language for computational design. By the end of this lesson, you will know how to use code blocks for numerical entry, string entry, sequences, and ranges. To get started, we will start a new blank Dynamo graph. Within our new graph, we will once again ensure that our run mode is on automatic. As a reminder, this is in the bottom left-hand corner of the Dynamo interface. First, we will review the nodal counterparts to the code blocks we will create. In this case, we will search for and add the following nodes: number, string, and range. These nodes placed, we will position them in a way that we can see all of their outputs. Now that we have these nodes placed and rearranged, we need to enter the correct data type into each of the nodes. For our number node, we'll enter a value of 5. For the string node, we will enter a value of hello Dynamo. And the range node, we will leave the default values. As a reminder, we can tell that the range node has default values thanks to the blue line next to the input ports. These nodes fulfilled, we can now create code block replacements for them. In order to better preview what is happening with each node, let's go ahead and add a watch node to each of their outputs. We can find the watch node by right-clicking and searching for watch. With watch nodes placed, we can go ahead and connect them to each of the nodes. I'm using a control copy for this operation. Now we're able to visualize what the nodal output is for each node. With these nodes fulfilled, we can go ahead and create code block replacements for each of them. In order to create a code block, we can simply double-click anywhere on the canvas. Code blocks are also available in the library under Script Editor. Typically, you'll double-click on the canvas for these though, but knowing where they are in the library is helpful. For our first code block, we're going to go ahead and replace the number node. Within the code block, we'll simply click and enter the number 5. With this fulfilled, we are able to preview the output and we can see that the number is 5. Let's go ahead and create another code block. With another double click on the canvas, we will create another code block, and we'll use this one to substitute the string value above. Inside of a code block, in order to enter a string value, you can click in the code block and type start quote hello Dynamo end quote. Clicking outside of the code block finalizes this change. And once again, we can preview this code block's output of hello Dynamo. One thing to keep in mind is code blocks support multiple lines of entry, and each line will end with a semicolon. For this example, we can go ahead and take our new string value and add it to the previous number code block on a new line. The easiest way to do this would be to click inside of the code block, press Ctrl C on our keyboard to copy, and paste it into our previous code block. As you will also notice, we have multiple output ports on this first code block, and the preview displays the last value within the code block. This time, we can go ahead and delete this other string code block. For the final node, we'll double-click for an additional code block on the canvas. At this point, we'll go ahead and enter the number 0, dot, dot, 9, dot, dot, 1. This is the code block representation of a range node. 0 is our start value, 9 is our end value, and 1 is our step value. We'll go ahead and click outside of this code block, we'll hover, and we'll pin its output now. In addition to hard-coded values within code blocks, we can add variables by simply typing variable names within the formula. In this case, we can change this newly created code block to the letter A, dot, dot, B, dot, dot, C. We'll click outside of the code block to finalize that change. The result of this operation is a code block with inputs available. We will also notice that the code block is in an error state, and that's because we are on run automatic. We can now fulfill these inputs with an additional code block with values. Let's move this over to the right. We'll zoom in a little bit, and we'll double click for a new code block. In this case, we'll type the number 2, semicolon, the number 20, semicolon, the number 5. We'll click outside of the code block to finalize this change once again. Code blocks in Dynamo are really intelligent in the way that they will automatically add outputs for us. So when you know that you're entering in a multi-line code block, you simply type semicolons and it will add outputs for you. These outputs can now be used for this previous code block that we created to represent a number range. We'll go ahead and make these connections now. With those connections complete, you will see a new output on the range code block that we created. This demonstrates the flexibility of code blocks in the sense that it can hold numbers, strings, or even formulas. In addition to using code blocks for strings, numbers, and formulas, you can call any regular node in the library through a code block as long as this node does not require a special user interface. For instance, if we navigate in the library to Geometry, Curves, and Circle, we will notice a node that we have used previously called Circle by Center Point Radius. This is a node we can call within a code block as well. In contrast, we could not call a node such as a watch node in a code block. This is because it has a special user interface, so it's not going to be able to preview the way that it should. Regular nodes generally come in three types: action, create, and query. In order to better demonstrate this, let's navigate to geometry, points, point. Within this category, we see create nodes. These are indicated by a green plus sign. We see action nodes, which are indicated with a yellow lightning bolt, and query nodes, which are indicated with a blue question mark. Thinking about points specifically, we can define each category as create for point creation nodes, action for moving points, and query for getting data about points. To invoke a point create node in a code block, we can start by placing a new code block. Let's do that now. Double click for a code block and we'll zoom in on it. Within this code block, we can go ahead and start entering the word point with a capital P. And as you can see, it's already predicting some data for us. When we enter a period or dot in the code block, Dynamo will help autocomplete the options available to us. For this example, let's go ahead and select the by coordinates option. To further investigate the options available, we can go ahead and type an open parenthesis. This results in the actions available to us. For reference, this is creating a point either by XY or by XYZ coordinates. To finish creating a point, we can go ahead and enter the number 0, 10, 5. And we need to end this by using a close parenthesis. Clicking outside of the code block will finalize this change, and this will create a point in the canvas. Hovering on the code block and pinning the preview will indicate the point that we created as well. Now that we have a point created with a code block, let's use an additional code block to query this item. We'll double click next to this code block for a new code block. In order to perform action or query options, we need to define a variable. This can be simply done by entering the letters PT for point, click outside of the code block to get an input port, and we'll connect the previous code block into this newly created code block. To query this object, we can use the values available to us in the library. Let's go ahead and click after PT and type in a period or dot, and we'll use the value of Z. We're using pt.z because this is available in our library under the query section. Keep in mind, you can always define variables in code blocks and add several lines of logic. Note, this new code block should read pt.z. Hovering on this code block and pinning the preview will show that result. And as you can see, we queried the point that we created previously for its z value. Keep in mind, you can always define variables in code blocks and add several lines of logic. To illustrate this, let's go ahead and remove this new code block. In our previous code block, with the point being created, let's declare a variable. We declare a variable by navigating to the beginning of the line and typing a variable name. In this case, let's type code block point space equal space with the remaining portion of the code after. This is now a variable that can be utilized within the same code block. We'll go ahead and click outside of it to finalize that change. Back in the code block, I'm going to copy this variable name by double-clicking it and pressing Ctrl-C on my keyboard. On the next line, we can go ahead and get to that by pressing Enter at the end of the first line. We can now use the variable like so, code block point dot z. Clicking outside of the code block will show us this new result. As you can see, we are querying that originally created point by coordinates with a variable name for its z value. Additionally, if you wanted to learn a little bit more about the DesignScript syntax available to us, you can always select a node, and we'll select one that we already created, right-click on the canvas, and use a feature called Node to Code. We'll go ahead and do this now. As you can see, we've created a code block that is very similar to the one we created earlier. Additionally, this code block has a variable name assigned automatically. Code blocks are extremely handy for quick data entry. I often use them in place of string nodes, number nodes, range nodes, or even in place of the getItemAtIndex node. In fact, code blocks can be used for so much more. In a later lesson in our advanced series of tutorials, we will cover additional features of code blocks for DesignScript and creating reusable definitions. To recap, in this lesson we covered how to use code blocks for data entry, how to use dot notation to query and create objects, and how to use node to code to quickly convert nodes to code blocks, and how to use that conversion to further understand DesignScript. I encourage you to explore node to code further in your own Dynamo graph creation and to experiment with code blocks as you make Dynamo graphs.